This is Amir Tsofati, and I'm live from home in Galilee. I'm sorry you might hear some flights of fighter jets, and I'll explain why in a few seconds. I'll wait to see that you guys are connected. These are breaking news, some very important things. Some of them are not great, but nevertheless, we have to talk about them. So let's see where you guys are from, where you're connecting from. Please write in your comments the city and the state that you're from. It'll be nice to see. Takes time to connect. Yeah. All right, connecting from Indiana, from Minnesota, people from Missouri, Kansas City, South Carolina, Kentucky. Who else is here? California is here in the house, Washington. Okay. All right, so folks, let me see if I can hold it like this. All right. Where do I start from? Today, over the weekend, we had some major escalations. If you remember the last time I was live, I told you that Israel eliminated the top Hamas commander inside the most secured area in Beirut, Lebanon, an area that is controlled and secured by Hezbollah. During the weekend, Hezbollah retaliated in very, very strong way with more than 60 missiles or anti-tank missiles that were fired directly at an Israeli strategic installation in the north. And thankfully, people were not killed, but there was some damage. Today, Israel managed to eliminate the commander of Hezbollah's elite force. It's called the Radwan forces. This is the commander units of Hezbollah that were trained to infiltrate into Israel and to do what Hamas did around Gaza, but they were trained to do it in Upper Galilee. Israel eliminated, it was a explosive device that exploded in his car, and he was killed. At the same time, a couple hours later, Israel killed the top Hamas commander in Syria. So two major people that were eliminated. But unfortunately, also Israel continues, you know, to maneuver, especially in the area of the city of Khan Yunis, where we believe the leaders of Hamas are now under the ground. We found the largest weapon manufacturing facility under the ground, and I'm talking about nearly 100. Over 100 foot under the ground, where they manufactured rockets. So we found a huge place, and it's all underneath humanitarian aid buildings, as always. There are some very bad things that happened today, which I'm not allowed to talk about because they're not yet allowed to be published. But this is one of the toughest evenings since the war had begun. And we're talking about a very bad and tragic incident that took place involving many soldiers. So I'm not going to talk about that, of course, until it's clear for publication. But I want you to follow me on Telegram, because I think the biggest problem we have right now is that Antony Blinken is landing in Israel today with a clear message from President Biden. Believe it or not, our friend in America wants us to stop fighting in Gaza. There are American hostages. Americans were killed. There's over 130 Israeli hostages in Hamas hands. And we haven't yet captured the leaders of Hamas, so we cannot really say that we're done. Israel is using semantic I would say gestures by saying that we moved now to the third phase of the war. But in reality, in the center of Gaza Strip, where Khan Yunis is, we have seven brigades above the ground and all of our elite forces underneath the ground. And so the war is not, it's far from being over. If anything, the war is going to last months in Gaza. And the thing is, we believe that there is not going to be any other option but to also fight Hezbollah, which is going to be even harder than fighting Hamas. So basically, what I wanted to say is that very significant elimination of terrorists today. One is of the leader or the commander of the Radwan forces. Again, the Radwan force is the elite forces of Hezbollah. That's their infantry commander soldiers. The rumors are that this guy that we eliminated, and I've got his name and his photos everywhere on Telegram. He was even photographed with Qasem Soleimani. The rumor is that this is the brother-in-law of Hassan Nasrallah, the leader of Hezbollah. So he's the brother of his wife. So very painful thing. Israel is moving right now major weapon systems to the northern border. We're basically getting ready for that war very soon. I can tell you that even here in my family, I will not tell you who, but members of my family, of this house, are called up to the north to take part in what is going to be in the very near future. So again, I'm not going to talk about the tragic incident, which is still not allowed to be published, but I will tell you that very significant elimination of two key people today. One is the commander of the Radwan forces in Lebanon, and the other one is the commander of Hamas in Syria. You see, Hamas is spreading all around because they want to make sure that they can operate all around, not only from Gaza. Israel continues to fight Hamas in Gaza, in the West Bank, but we are fighting war that is also in Syria, and also parts of Iraq, and Red Sea, of course, Judea, Samaria, Gaza, and Lebanon. Quite a few fronts simultaneously. We could use your prayers for two major things. One is, of course, we've got the situation of the loss of quite a few soldiers. So we need a lot of prayer for families and for the nation. but also we are on a path for direct confrontation with the United States. President Biden, in a year of election, he doesn't want to anger the far left. He also wants the votes of the Muslims in Michigan. He can't afford losing anyone from his potential bank of voters. So now we feel the pressure here of the coming elections in America. I can tell you, folks, from stuff that I know, and I am not going to say more than I can because I don't want to be banned on Facebook and YouTube, but I will tell you that a lot of military folks in America don't sleep at night because of what they know that China is planning. I will not get into details, but what I know is, let's put it this way, what China can do to America is far worse than what Hamas can do to Israel. So, and these are very, very troubling things. And the problem is that President Biden wants to stay passive throughout this year of election, and which is exactly what all the enemies of Israel and America want. They want him to just have a show of force, but not use it. By the way, quite a few American soldiers were hit. Some of them were killed in U.S. bases in Syria. Over 150 incidents of pro-Iranian militias attacking U.S. bases already took place since the middle of October, and very, very few retaliations from the Americans. Biden brings the Navy and Air Force and so many things, and yet America is not using them for some strange reason. So a lot of stuff is going to happen. 2024 is a year that will really keep us on our knees. That's what I can tell you. So pray for Israel as we go through this tough time. But also, again, there's a direct confrontation between Israel and America in the very, very near future surrounding the Gaza and the Lebanon borders. Israel cannot afford its own citizens being refugees in our own countries. You know, northern Israel is empty from civilians. All the area around Gaza is empty. And we're talking about nearly 200,000 Israelis that are stuck in hotels and in some other places because they cannot go back home. This cannot continue. We have to do something about it. We have to bring back security. And so and so this is the situation right now. And again, very, very important elimination in Lebanon and in Syria, and a very tough incident in Gaza. Look, a lot of people complain that they can't find me on Telegram. And the reason why is because they followed the wrong channel. They follow the channel that was an imposter who had 14,000 subscribers instead of following me with 478,000 subscribers. So when he's not posting anything or blocking some people, they think I did it. So he's also asking for money from people. He's also, and then if you don't give him something, he'll block you. And then you think I did that. So please, guys, my Telegram channel has 478,000 subscribers. Any other channel with my name on it is not mine. Unfollow and maybe even report and follow the right one. Okay? All right. Thank you. God bless you.